Welcome to an example of permutations and probability involving permutations. For reference, we have some notes down here in red for the definition of probability and the definition of a permutation. In this example, five comedians are planning a show. Their names are listed here. The order of each performance is randomly selected. The first question is, how many different orders are possible? So because the order matters, we need to use a permutation rather than a combination. We could also use the counting principle, which we'll discuss in just a moment. So because there are five comedians and all five are going to be ordered, the number of different orders would be 5 permute 5, which can be written in several ways. One way is 5 permute 5, or we could use this notation down here below. Either way, n permute r is equal to n factorial divided by n minus r factorial. So in this case, we would have 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 5 factorial, 0 factorial. Well, 0 factorial is equal to 1, so this is just equal to 5 factorial, or 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 120. So there are 120 different orders possible. Let's also take a look at this using the counting principle. For the counting principle, we view this as a series of events where, since there are 5 people being ordered, there will be 5 series of events. We'll determine the product of the number of ways each event can occur. So for example, anybody can be first, or any of the 5 comedians. So there are 5 ways we can select the first position. There are 4 ways to select the second position. There are 3 ways to select the third position. There are only 2 comedians left, so there are 2 ways to select the fourth position and 1 way to select the last position. Notice how this product would be 5 factorial, giving us the same result. And now for the second question, we want to know, what is the probability Joe will go second? Again, we can use a permutation, or we can also use the counting principle, but either way, to find the probability, we want to find the number of favorable ways this can occur and divide by the total number of ways we can order the comedians. So if there are 5 positions to fill, and we want Joe to be second, notice there are only 4 positions to be filled, and therefore, the favorable number of ways this can occur would be by permuting the 4 remaining comedians. So 4 permute 4 would be the favorable number of ways that Joe would be second, divided by the total number of ways that we can order the 5 comedians, which we already know is 120, which would be 5 permute 5, which we already know is 120. For 4 permute 4, by definition, that would be 4 factorial divided by 0 factorial, or just 4 factorial, 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 24. So the probability of Joe being second would be 24 over 120. But this does simplify. This is both divisible by 24. So this simplifies to 1/5. Probability can be expressed as a decimal and a percentage as well. This is also equal to 0.2 or 20%. But I do want to go back to the counting principle just for a moment. If we know Joe is second, and there's only one way that can occur, again, if he is second, leaving us with 4 options for the first position, 3 options for the third position, 2 options for the fourth position, and 1 option for the fifth position, notice how this would be 4 factorial, or 24, the same as 4 permute 4. Finally, for our last example, we want to know, what is the probability Joe will go second and Beth will go last? So again, we have 5 positions. We want to know the number of ways that Joe can be second and Beth can be last or fifth. So first, using permutations, the favorable number of ways would be the number of ways we can fill the remaining positions. There are 3 comedians. And we want to order all three of them, so that would be 3 permute 3. The total number of ways is still 120, or 5 permute 5. So our denominator is 120. And again, 3 permute 3 is equal to 3 factorial divided by 0 factorial, or 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 6. And this fraction simplifies as well. Common factor of 6. So we have 1 over 20, which is a decimal would be 0.05. As a percent, that would be 5%. Remember, a fraction bar means division. So to convert a fraction to a decimal, we divide. 1 divided by 20 is equal to 0.05. To convert a decimal to a percentage, we multiply by 100, or move the decimal point to the right two places, and add a percent symbol. And before we go, let's discuss how we could have used the counting principle to come up with the favorable number of ways. Again, if Joe is second and Beth is fifth, there are three remaining comedians. So we have three ways to select the first position. There's only one way that Joe can be second. Now there's only two comedians remaining, so there are two ways to fill the third position, one way to fill the fourth position, and because Beth has to be fifth, there's one way for that. Notice that this is equal to 3 factorial, or 6, which we have for 3 permute 3. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you for watching.